talking about the trend of straight girls kissing each other, and it's not just in the bar scene. Young girls are even doing it on the school bus. The school bus. All right, but that doesn't shock 15-year-old Dana and her twin sister Jill. Okay, so Dana, you kissed on the school bus?
Yeah, I was 14 and I was on a summer school bus, and there's a bunch of guys around us because me and my friend were the only two girls. And they came up to us and they're like, oh, you guys should kiss, come on, it would be hot, do it. So we just did.
You kissed?
Yeah.
What kind of kiss? Was it like a, or was it a?
It was like a peck. It wasn't more like.
Okay.
Because we were 14, so.
Okay, but you've moved up now.
A little.
And so the boys pushed you into that?
Yeah, they did. We get a lot of pressure from them.
Do you get more popular after?
Yeah, like you get a lot more attention and you're invited to more parties and stuff. So, yeah. Because
okay.
You're like the life of the party, I guess. Because they're like, oh, come on, it's hot. They're like, oh, they're hot. They do this. So, yeah.
They're hot. They do this. Okay. So, Jill, how do you feel about this?
I think it's gross because my sister doesn't need to do that to get attention from guys. Like, she's pretty. She's talkative. She's really outgoing. She just needs to go up to someone and they'll start laughing and she'll have more mm-hmm. friends. And I don't want people to like lose respect for her or think she's a skank because she does that, because she's not.
Why do you think you like that attention from guys?
It just like feels good, you know? They're like, oh, you're so hot. You're, they want like to chill with you and stuff.
Why do you think your sister doesn't need to do that?
I don't know. She just has like a really likable personality. Everybody wants to be around her all the time.
And you don't think people want to be around you unless you kiss boys?
I don't know. It's different, I guess.
Do you ever feel like jealous of attention that your sister gives?
Yeah, all the time. Oh my gosh.
Tell me about that.
She's just like always the really outgoing one that's always with all the guys all the time, all the friends. Like I have friends too, but she just gets to do a lot more stuff.
Mm-hmm. Does that hurt you to hear that your sister has maybe a little bit of a jealousy and is doing this to get the attention that you get?
A little bit, because she doesn't need to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Like.
Okay. Have you ever felt a pressure to kiss girls, Jill?
Yes, I have, but I don't kiss girls.
Mm-hmm.
I was at a party one time, and we were playing Truth or Dare, and it was mostly guys and me and my best friend. And these guys dared me and my best friend to make out, and we're like, oh, no, it's not going to happen, you know? And they were kind of upset, like, right after it happened, but mm-hmm. me and the guys are still friends. We're still cool. So.
Tell me what happens, Dana, when you're at a party, like a little teen party, and that song comes on. Girl, what happens?
Whenever that song comes on, there's always like a bunch of guys going up to girls, and they're like, oh, this is a song, come on, you gotta do it now, you gotta do it. And then I guess people usually do it, and it's like, after all the girls are like, ooh, her cherry chapstick, and it's crazy.
Okay. And tell me, you were watching television one day, and you saw a star on TV, and it made you go, wow, that's cool. Who'd you see on TV?
Oh. Madonna and Britney Spears at the VMAs. That is like the famous one.
And so
famous kiss.
And what did that make you think when you saw that?
Well, I was younger. I was just like, oh my gosh, Britney and Madonna.
And you're like, I'm gonna do that. So Jill, what do you wanna tell your sister about this kissing that what do you wanna tell her? Why don't you turn to her now and take her hands and why don't you tell her how pretty she is and how great she is? She doesn't need to do this for attention.
I think it's gross. You really don't need to do that. You're really pretty. Guys always are looking at you, and guys are always with you. I don't know what you're talking about. Like, you don't need to do that.
Do you think you could try to find a way to get people's attention?
Yeah.
And not doing that?
You're right. I really, like, don't have to do that, but.
But you're going to keep on.
No. I don't know. Now that I've realized, like, if it upsets my twin sister that much, I really shouldn't do it because I really care about what she thinks of me and stuff.
Yeah, but it's not about her, right? Like, let's put it back on you, okay? Because I don't think it's about, oh, I don't want to upset my twin sister. This is your life. And what I hear is a girl that she just wishes she could be popular and she wishes people could like her and she wishes people could come around her like they do her twin sister. She wishes boys would, like, just come around. But that's not the only way to get attention. And it's really not about getting attention. You understand? It's about being happy with yourself and not feeling that need. And you're so young. What are you, 15 years old? Do you know what that attention turns to when you become an adult?
Dad, you look skanky and trashy, and I don't want to look like that. Okay.
When you get older, when women my age want attention from guys and they're desperate to do it, you know, they go all the way with a lot of people all the time. And they're doing it because they're empty inside. Mm-hmm. So we want to stop that right now. So I want you to spend some time with your sister and talk to her about how you feel inside, how you don't feel as great as her or as special, or you don't get that attention. And I think you guys being twins have that bond and that power. You can put your foreheads together and do that teen stuff that you guys, that teen twin stuff, and really figure that out, okay? I think that's really important. And I know your mama's here.
Yeah, my mommy is here.
I'm gonna talk to her when we come back. We'll be right back. So we were just talking to Dana and Jill, and Dana says that she kisses girls. These are twin sisters, and Jill says she's not happy that her twin sister is kissing girls. Now we have mama here, Lisa. Lisa, how do you feel about this, about your daughter kissing girls for attention from boys?
Nothing surprises me. There's such a strong competition between twins. And Dana is an attention seeker. That's just her nature. I've tried to give them the tools to make the right decisions with their life, but I can't think for them, and I can't always be with them. And they have to make some decisions on their own. I hope they'll make the right choices. It disappoints me that she would do that for attention, because she's beautiful, she's popular, and she always has more male attention than I would like to see her have.
But she's saying that she doesn't feel good enough. That's pretty much what she was saying before you were sitting here.
Right.
What does that make you feel like as a mom, that she doesn't feel good enough and she has to use sexuality at such a young age and in such a public way to feel good enough?
It makes me sad that she's insecure. I've always tried to make all three of my daughters feel good about themselves, but some of that has to come from within. Dana's going to have to mature and realize that she's a wonderful person in her own right, and she doesn't have to do stupid things to impress boys, because historically women have always done stupid things to impress men. It's the way it is.
Tell Dana, why don't you tell your mom how you feel and why you do it?
I just did it because we were at a party or anything, and people were like, just do it, it's not a big deal. And like, seriously, like, it's not a big deal to kiss a boy. So it was just like, oh, well, it wasn't like, you know, like crazy, but it just kind of happened. And I wouldn't do that to like upset you or anything, because you know I'm straight. I have a boyfriend. I'm not like not straight.
But tell your mom how you're feeling inside and what you do to make yourself feel better. Do you understand what I mean? What you told me earlier?
Yeah, I mean, like, when you do it, like, guys are like, oh, you're so hot, that's so sexy, and it just kind of makes you feel good about yourself. Like, they're like, oh, you're hot, like, that's good. But I guess if you're putting yourself on that level, it's not the best in any way.
Well, I would hope you'd feel good about yourself without a boy having to tell you that.
Where do you think that comes from? Where do you think that comes from, your daughter seeking that male attention so strongly? Do you know where it comes from with her?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
It's hard to say.
Well, it looks like more some family reflection needs to happen, right?
Always.
Because it looks like a little problem right now, but there's a deeper issue, I think.
But she's very young, and I don't want it to turn into a bigger problem. Mm-hmm.
All right, so you're going to do your mama thing. Okay, we'll be right back.